Welcome back to another episode of Who the Fuck. It's the show that aims to take a deep dive in some acts announced at Reading and Leeds 2019. In today's video, we're looking at Nav. He's a rapper from Canada. If you've never heard of him before, hopefully this video will help answer the question, who the fuck is Nav?
Whack, whack, whack. One phone call, get you whack, whack, whack. Try to slap me, we gon' let it slap, slap, slap. Cross the line, it's too late, you can't take it back, back, back.
Navraj Singh Goraya, simply known as Nav, is a rapper, songwriter, producer based out of Rexdale, Ontario, Canada. So I believe that's not too far from Toronto.
Toronto is in Ontario?
Yeah, I think so. He reminds me a lot of kind of current rappers, people like Migos, in the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry. Drake.
I got enemies, got a lot of enemies, got a lot of people trying to drain me of this energy.
Travis Scott.
I get those goosebumps every time, I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side.
He released his first record, Take Me Simple.
Take me simple, I swear you won't take me simple again. If you take me simple, I swear you won't take me simple again.
On SoundCloud in 2015, and in July of 2015, we'll go on to collaborate with Drake on his diss track for Meek Mill, Back to Back. He was the producer. In 2016, Drake would go on to use the track Take Me Simple and The Man on his Beats 1 radio show called OVO Sound. Also in 2016, Nav would go on to collaborate with Travis Scott on the track, on the song Biebs in the Trap.
Versace my clothes, I wear a white hoe and she's snorting three lines like Adidas.
Yep. Taken from his album, Birds in the Trap, Sing McKnight. Is that the one with Goosebumps? It's a good album, that one. In February 2017, he signed a record deal with both EXO Records and Republic Records. Can't believe we're featuring two Republic Records artists in the same day. EXO Records is the label that is founded by The Weeknd, and both them and Republic are Universal labels that are owned by Universal Music. He would then go on to produce his first commercial mixtape, simply self-titled Nav, which would include the record Someway featuring The Weeknd. Also in 2017, he would go on to release the collaboration mixtape with Metro Boomin, the producer, which would feature Offset from Migos, Lil Uzi Vert, 21 Savage, and Gucci Mane. In 2018, he released his debut solo album Reckless on both EXO and Republic Records. And apparently in January, he announced his retirement following Lil Uzi Vert's announcement as well. I forgot that Lil Uzi Vert said that. I put that in the video I did for him as well. And yet both of them are playing Reading and Leeds. Interesting. They're playing the same day? No, they're not. The next bit, I'm just gonna read from Wikipedia because it's just completely absurd. On March 14th, Nav's manager Amir Cash Esmilan said he was tired of hunting Nav for his hard drive for music, so he decided to release the Brown Boy EP on his behalf. Following this, Lil Uzi posted on Instagram to tell Nav that the EP was amazing and that he should come out of retirement. Nav officially announced the end of his 2-month retirement on Instagram by announcing the release of his upcoming album Bad Habits. So he was never going to fucking retire, was he? He was making an album. Pisses me off. Liar. Stupid marketing ploy. In March of 2019, Nav released his second album, Bad Habits, on both EXO and Republic Records again, and would feature guest appearances from Meek Mill, Young Thug, The Weeknd, and Gunna. His most popular record is his feature on Travis Scott's Biebs in the Trap.
Night, night. Yeah. Flash, spotlight, cooler.
Currently sat on 114 million hits on YouTube, but his most popular record is the track Someway featuring The Weeknd.
Way, we got a feeling some way, way, cause you see EXO in the place, total way.
Currently sat on 57 million hits on YouTube. This is his first time playing Reading and Leeds. He's taking to the Radio 1 stage. I didn't realise we had that many Radio 1 stage artists left to do. On the Saturday at Reading, Sunday at Leeds, playing in between King Princess and Roddy Ricch. Now, you should know, if you've been watching this series, my opinion on a lot of hip-hop. I absolutely love hip-hop, but there's a lot that I really don't like. This is in the latter half. In addition, he mentions how dissatisfied he is that TMZ didn't take photos of him when he was wearing all of his jewellery, stepping into his Lamborghini. Couple that with the fact that he's likely to be clashing with Bexy and Jaguar Skills, I know where I would rather be dishing out my time. So on the likely to see scale, I'm going to be going with a 1 out of 10. What do you think? Are you excited to see Nav at this year's festival? Have you seen him perform before? Opinions. Clearly he's quite a talented guy. You know, he's not like a mumble rapper in the same sense that, like, Lil Uzi Vert and Lil Pump and Lil Yachty and all those shit artists are. But yeah, it's not like Nas or Kanye or Jay-Z or J. Cole or Kendrick. Like, that's my kind of thing. I'd love to know what you have to say. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below as always, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers. Bye.